I'm back here in Massachusetts. I'm actually at White's Music Education Center where I used to teach drums. Anyway, I'm back. I'm not here to teach. I'm here to prep John's drums for tour. So I had them sent here because we start in New England. And what I'm doing is, some of you might remember back in 2013, I built John's new U.S. kit, which was the red. It's the red and black fade Pearl Masters kit. I spent a couple days in Nashville building that kit, and I did updates on my YouTube channel. You can look back for those if you'd like. So I built that kit, and I kind of showed you every step of the way. It has internal miking and, you know, a bunch of other stuff going on with it. But anyway, this time, what we're doing for this new record is, as most people know, John is a huge horror movie fan. All the old school horror movies, you know, especially Jaws, of course, but, you know, the last tour we had Jaws drum heads on the front of his bass drums. This time we're doing a monster theme rap on his kit, and the great people at BumWrap Drum Company in Maryland made these wraps for John. So I am here for a couple days stripping his kit, the entire kit, down to the shells. I'm going to start today. Well, I started yesterday, but today I'm going to do a snare drum and a couple other drums. As you can see here, I have a snare drum, this Pearl hybrid exotic snare drum, which he loves, and I'm going to change it into the Wolfman. But I will show you that when I'm done. I'm going to go strip the drum, and I will see you in a few. Okay. Okay, so here is the snare drum shell stripped, no hardware, and here's what the wrap looks like. I'll change it to the Wolfman. Pretty easy application. Wrap it, clamp it, stick it, put all the hardware back on. So I'll show you when it's done. Okay, here it is. The Wolfman drum. See, wasn't that easy? kind of not. Wolfman on this side too. You know, it's hard to kind of figure where you're gonna put stuff because there's so many lug casings to avoid, but you know, it's practically impossible anyway. Anyway, that's done. I'm going to re-head it later, but that's it. All right. That's how it's done. I'll show you the whole kit later. Bye.
You're recording.
Hey, guys, this is my nephew, Seth. He's very embarrassed to be on camera right now, but
I'm very embarrassed.
He's been helping me build John's new kit. And which drums did you build? You built the 18-inch floor tom and a couple of the bass drums, both the bass drums.
Yep.
Helped me build them. He cut all the holes for the hardware and stuff, and he's been a great help.
Thank you. You've
probably seen Seth in some of my previous videos playing his guitar. He's quite the guitar player. But anyway, I'm going to give you a tour of John's new kit, the 2016 Monster Kit. So I'm going to hand the camera over to Seth, and he'll show you the new kit. So here it is, 2016 Monster Kit. Where to begin? Let's start with the bass drums. We have Gorgo on the bass drums, I think that's his name. With Jaws drum heads, we have Gorgo. This wrap was done by BumWrap Company in Maryland. Over here, we have the Creature from the Black Lagoon on the 18 down here. Came out pretty good up here. We have Paul Toombs. This is actually Vincent Price playing Paul Toombs in Madhouse. Over here on the 12 is good old Frankenstein. And down here is Nosferatu on the 13. Now the 14 is something special. John is good friends with Jerry, only from the Misfits. And when Jerry heard that John was going to do a Monster Kid, he promised to put Jerry on the drum. So this is Jerry's drum, the 14. And then down here we have King Kong. I don't know if you saw King Kong earlier, but the original black and white King Kong is here. And then next to him on the 16-inch floor tom is Ingrid Pitt. what was the Countess Dracula? That's what she played. She's been in a bunch of horror films. And then on the 16-inch floor tom over here is, of course, the Dracula. I believe that's Bela Lugosi. So as we make around our way around the kit, last but not least, on the snare drum, we have the Wolfman. Get in on that. John's rocking the new Redline pedals, both on the hi-hat and the bass drums. They have a bunch of new features. They're kind of like the Eliminator he used to use, which is same model, kind of. The changes are the footboard's a little different, it's a little wider shaped, and the color is different. They're gray instead of black, red pads instead of black, and the quad beater is more balanced, and the spring mechanism's better as well. The other things he changed on the kit are these heads. We went back to the EC2s, all the way around the toms, and then we went back to the ST Dry on the snare drum. He used to use the black Onyx all the way around, and they were good, they sounded good, but these sound a little better, they're a little brighter, so John wanted to try it for this tour, so we'll see how they go. And that's it. It took me like 3 days or so to take everything off the kit. I had to take all the miking systems out. Strip the whole, the kit, put the wraps on, make sure they were on right, put all the hardware back on, all the mics back in, and that's it. So this is his monster kit. And of course the bobbleheads, right?
Oh yeah.
Of course all the monster bobbleheads. So thanks a lot for watching, everybody. As always, thanks for watching, and look for us on tour with Killswitch Engage and Black Wizard. Black Nest is what I call him. A Black Wizard will be with us, and this will be the kick you'll see in the U.S.
You're supposed to fall over.